me and their network.
It hasn't.
I'd get ready for reinforcements.
Are you fucking gay?
A lot of reinforcements.
You?
You gay, yeah? Get him.
Sword unsheathing noises.
I'm a little quirky with that joke. I kind of like it.
I'm not even gonna say anything. I deserve that.
He said sword unsheathing noises. You fucking 100% deserve that.
Everything in the bit, yeah?
Jazz music stops, haha, buddy.
Thanks for moving that tank out of the way.
I'm ashamed now.
Fucking just
and we didn't blow up.
Yeah, not blowing up is as good as you can hope for sometimes.
Way to reach for the stars.
Don't you know I'm the only one who can do things, jerks?
Yeah. Shut the fuck up. The cringe master.
Yeah, but when the cringe master is saying that's too cringy, you know it's pretty bad.
You know. You got a point there.
The guy that thrives off cringe is like, you're fucking cringy. That's like when the school shooter kid like sits away from you. It's like, you know you have a problem.
Jesus.
Well, this looks familiar.
And, down bad. Down bad.
Damn, you bussin' and down bad, aren't you?
Don't say those things.
Oh shit. Bacon barbecue.
We're inside the ship.
Bussin.
Son can't be far now.
Could be some really weird defenses in there. Not just flame turrets. I'm talking.
Oh,
real.
Why did I get my accent go off my spell?
I like this place better when there wasn't a Cabal tank in it.
Don't mess with them. They need to stay focused. Why would they put a tank inside a ship?
Zahn's running scared. Don't let up.
Yeah, that's Putin!
Yes.
Yes, Rasputin.
The elevator?
Oh, come
good
on.
Good boy.
Another one?
Good
no,
boy.
The tank. Now comes the elevator.
Now back to him.
Let me get these kills.
Oh!
Or not. That's
I did.
Sorry, Cameron. I literally held it down as you said that. I'm sorry.
Alright.
We're a smart group of individuals here.
I'm running a build for anything. That's fine.
You got more enemies up ahead. We'll leave those for you.
Yeah, but I have to
we'll
get like 5 kills in a row with an SMG to get charged.
In a row?
I think I can have, like, maybe 2 or 3 seconds in between kills, kind of like Rampage.
I need more helmets like this.
Like a bounty hunter?
Yeah, a little visor helmet.
There he is! Rocket Zahn is here!
Try to grab his
maybe they'll start bringing back Deal on Armor.
That's all they can do now. They have lost faith. They have lost my faith in them to make good art. Make it work.
Bring on through to the other side.
Bring on through to the other side. You know the day destroys the night. Night divides the day. Night to run. Night to hide. We're going through to the other side.
What fucking game did that song used to be in? It was like a main
I know the Snoop Dogg version of it was in Need for Speed Underground 2.
Maybe that's kind of where
there's a Snoop Dogg version?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna have to listen to that now.
Alright. I'm gonna bubble us as soon as he pops up.
Almost back to the surface.
Watch for air support. This guy's too smart to not have a backup plan.
Yeah, backup plans are overrated.
The deepers, man. The deepers on that boy.
We did it! Zahn won't be making any more scary new weapons for the Red Legion.
Oh, they'll have to use regular old weapons.
I'm so happy.
Those we can handle. Nice job.
Burp. Bungie's next games are going to be like.
Dog shit.
Like, if they actually made a PvP-focused game where they could do all the balancing they need to do, it might actually be pretty good. Then I would have Destiny for PvE and whatever other game for
Guardian. PvP. We've picked up a high gain transmission.
I feel like if Origin they were going to do that, they would turn it into like a hero shooter thing. Cosmodrome. Or even maybe like something like Apex, where it's like there's a select That's amount of guns and then AI like warmonger. Heroes can choose
if I'm
to add
understanding
abilities.
Him correctly, it's a distress call.
So like you could craft so and have some flexibility with loadouts.
It'd be a shame to lose him.
But then like there would be a, like five characters you could use and they could balance the abilities. If they were going to do an ability-centric thing, or if they're just legit going to do a straight-up FPS.
I really didn't mind Apex for a battle royale game. I don't like battle royale games, but Apex was actually pretty decent.
Movement.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what? They added a 3v3 mode to Apex.
Oh, did they really?
Mm-hmm.
There was like a, I can't remember what. There was a reason that kind of made me not want to play it. I'm sure because it's battle royale, but I think there was something else that kind of annoyed me. But I did like the way the game felt. Felt like
Apex gets really unbalanced with new heroes. Heroes are always really fucking unbalanced. They may have played like around the time when like a new hero came out.
When we played, the OP hero that just came out was the one that could go like into portals and shit. The woman.
Mm-hmm.
And
oh,
it just
woman.
Ruined it. Yeah, it was a woman. I mean, to make things worse, am I right? Good thing it wasn't a black woman.
Nice guy.
Trying to be as offensive as possible right now.
Imagine if it was a transgender black woman. Oh my god.
Isn't that just a man?
No. Don't ever say that again.
Well, no,
how
like, so.
Like, how dare
you? Transgender woman, like, would, like, a girl trying to be a guy? I thought you were talking about, like, guy turning into girl. That's why I said.
Did you just say womp womp?
Sorry.
Get out of here.
For putting Telesto on me.
What?
What?
Matt?
Wasn't me. No.
Yeah, it's the only guy running Telesto on a fucking fire team.
Yeah, Nate, you fucking noob. Get the fuck out of here.
Sorry this is taking so long. But these
You're just a big stinker.
I'm actually not that
oh, yeah?
Just a big, stinky, nice guy.
Nice
person.
Person.
Guardian down.
Oh, my
fault.
Who the hell died, man? That them gamer man did it.
I don't want to hear anything.
Then just close your ears.
I'll fucking pull us to orbit, dude.
Oh, no. anybody?
Hey, motherfucker.
Wait, that's my kid.
Party cola?
I hate it when vandals go invisible and then just run, like, right next to your feet, away from you. Like, at least melee me.
Dude, this guy's doing circles around me. Fuck you.
Freaking stupid guys.
Could try to hack us, please. But Rasputin might hit us.
Idiots.
These systems already stressed.
Never say that.
It worked. Maybe too well.
Someday we'll establish communications with the war mind. Speak to it. Understand it. If we are ever to reach a second goal, it will be with Rasputin at our side.
You know what? You can take this. You're tidy.
Ah, cool, I got stuck. Zooming! Zooming! Oh, fucking Christ, you killed me, Nate!
No! Put it in!
Oh, did I get it? Oh, I almost died.
Yeah, you got it.
Okay. Oh, behind you, Cameron.
Inorganic life form. I just want to note that Rasputin has a much better setup than I do. He has a secret bunker with space weapons. I live in your backpack.
He has a secret bunker with space weapons. I live in a backpack. I don't have a backpack. But thank you for your fucking quirky commentary.
Shank's been modified to crack his system. Let's take it out.
Sure.
another prime number. So many.
Get him to understand we're allies.
The last time we sent him a team was years ago. We found what remained of their buddies scattered across the Skywatch.
Killing Wind Thresh.
Noted.
In the meantime, I'm sending a team to seal the vault. All thanks to you, Guardian. Impressive work.
I'm forgetting to buy the keycode.
Disgraced? 15 different subscriptions to watch fucking shows I want to watch. Like, I want to watch Invincible, but I don't want to fucking pay for an Amazon Prime subscription to get Prime Video.
Oh, it's on
Amazon. Huh. Isn't Prime pretty expensive, too?
I think it's only, like, 15 per month or something like that, but it's, like, $15 to, like, watch a show? Are you fucking serious?
Yeah, you definitely have to have other uses for
and
it.
And Amazon Prime doesn't have anything good either.
Yeah, Prime Video.
Yeah. Since my mom had it, and I was looking through it, and it just looks like a fucking waste.
It's just like, Apple TV. Like, there's nothing good on there except, like,
Apple TV
sucks,
dude.
Older one
people.
Or two shows. But other than that, everything else sucks.
Yeah. It's not too bad, but
all on raiding party ahead. You don't seem thrilled about the voter's presence.
I see they're doing a new thing on Hulu. Cause like you can look up other shit. It's like, oh, to watch this you need to pay extra a month or whatever. Fuck you.
Like, if you want the AMC shit, gotta pay an extra dumbass premium price bullshit.
I think it's because none of the streaming stuff is, like, regulated in the same way cable is. That's kind of what, like, DirecTV and all of them would do for you, is that they would just say, hey, for one flat rate, we will give you all these things.
Yeah. And they probably get a better price on it, so you don't have to pay as much.
But the fucking commercials. These things, you get no commercials, but it's like, then you're spending way more than cable to get.
And on Hulu, you pay
all
that money, and
you
still
get commercials.
still get commercials, which is just bullshit.
Yeah.
Although that's probably why Netflix is like losing money or whatever.
Yeah, they don't have it. Netflix is also staying true to who they are as a platform, which is appreciated.
I am pretty pissed at Netflix, so they took off the fucking Office.
They took off a lot of shit.
Yeah. They can't have huge shows like that on their platform for fucking ever. Do you know how long The Office has been on fucking Netflix?
Yeah, but
it's running allies.
Yeah, I got that too. Yeah.
Yeah, it does that when you go too long.
Never seen that on this screen.
Yeah, for some reason, if you slide underneath, it'll give you that message. Oh. And you walk like 4 feet and then it goes away. Yeah, I mean, it's for the same reason why I think they took How I Met Your Mother off. Probably another war sound. I think I remember them doing that. Because that used to be a show I would just basically watch, like, reruns of all the fucking
pubs. Okay.
What the fuck happened to me? Oh, it pushed me into a corner where I didn't know where I was going.
We're close now. She won't escape this time.
Retreat isn't an option for her anymore.
It's all this fucking streaming shit. It's getting out of hand, and I see definitely within like the next 10 years or so, it get like wrangled up, and it becomes a lot easier.
That's her.
Yeah.
That's Nabota.
That's surprisingly why, like, I know this is mean, but there's a site called Verve that basically gives you like Funimation culture and all that, just to you pay it through their platform. Is, I think, nice, and I wish, like, all these other networks would do that, too. It's like, hey, just one flat thing, and you get everything.
I think Disney Plus did something like that, where you get a deal or buy everything. It was like some other fucking network or something.
Wait, but it's all, like, Disney stuff.
I think there's like more stuff. I haven't seen it.
Well, the one nice thing too is Peacock's pretty cheap. I got $5.
What is it? Oh man. You gonna lag out?
Lagging. A little bit. Yeah, you're lagging bad, dude. Holy shit.
You can't hear anything. Funny enough, that's the only thing that came through clear. They did again.
Hello. Like it?
I think it's better. I think so.
Anyway.
Oh, maybe not.
Trying to talk about the oh my
fucking serious guys.
The $5.
You killed me with your fucking rocket, X-Men. Cause it exploded all the exploders.
The voters play for power, shield, and danger high.
The Peacock is like $5, and that's what we use for Supercross, which is nice. Oh. Instead of, because we were talking about getting the Gold membership, which is like $100 to get all the sport channels, and it has the Supercross and Outdoors, but which was fucking ridiculous.
That's a big jump. That's a pretty big price jump there.
Yeah, because like I said before, we found Peacock, we're all sitting down talking about it, and we're just like, well, let's just all chip in and get it. But like I said, I'm not spending that much for just to watch Supercross for a season.
That's the thing too, is that, like, we used to pay for like NFL All Access and stuff, but it was like a lot of fucking money to pay just to like watch football.
How much was that?
It was upwards in the hundreds. Oh, just for basically, the thing was though is that it gave you every single football game, like all of them.
Mm-hmm. Oh, even like the ones that nobody watches.
Mhm. Yeah. So it was like you literally could watch all the games. But again, it's a lot of fucking money. Especially
some
when
games
they
I don't really
recently
watch.
Yeah. The thing was is that we were getting it because 9 times out of 10 Packer games don't get televised in California, unless it's a like a bigger game, like the midday game, the night game, or like a Thursday or Monday game. Mm-hmm. If it's not one of those, it probably won't even get televised.
Mm. That's stupid.
It'll be more of like the kind of West Coast teams that get televised out here.
Yeah. We'll see how you get for that. Yeah, that makes sense.
But
plus, half the time we watch football, we just fucking we hop through every game and watch like one quarter or something, or watch half of it just to kind of see, so it's not like you watch the full thing anyways.
Dad stopped fucking watching football altogether though, because he was like, them Negroes is getting too political.
They are. They really are.
But he was basically just stopped watching because he was like, why are they taking a knee? And I was like, what is it? What's the fucking game?
Well, Cameron, did you ever play Madden yet?
Yeah, I played a little bit. I don't know.
If you look at on the back of every football helmet, it says end racism. At the end of each fucking touchdown, it says end racism. And there's even, like, when you score a touchdown, you can, like, do different moves, and one is fucking get on one knee. It's like, Jesus Christ. I just want to play football.
They must be pissing a lot of people off.
Well, you gotta think about it too. If they didn't do that, no one would buy their game, so I'm sure they're forced into doing that.
It's not even that nobody would buy their game, it's just buying into the majority.
No, it's buying into critics and shit. That's what it's buying into. Because I see one thing wrong with the game and then blow it out of proportion.
Man, who's racist is because they didn't put any racism on their helmets.
Like, in general, Destiny is one of the best PvE fucking shooters you can play.
It's kind of also the only good one, you know?
Yeah.
Like, don't get me wrong, like, Borderlands is fun, but Borderlands is fun for, like, day. When you finish the story,
it's fun until it's not.
Yeah, and then you grind all your weapons and you're like, well, nothing to do.
But
like, look at us.
You're always gonna get something.
Yeah, we're playing strikes just to play them right now. That's a fun loop, and it feels good. That's always a huge factor too, is that the game has to feel good. If it doesn't feel good, like the movement, the gunplay, and like all that stuff, if it doesn't feel good, you're not gonna play it for hours upon hours.
Yeah,
which is
I'm
why
never
I was skeptical of Outriders.
Yeah, I didn't pay for Outriders, so I was no water off my back either way. Just Retro paid for it, but yeah, it was fun to a point.
Or like Anthem, like sometimes Anthem felt good, but other times it felt really clunky.
Well, the only time for me Anthem felt bad is like when it was just having connectivity issues.
Yeah.
That I loved the movement. I loved the free range mobility, the all that shit. It was fucking fun. Oh my god, it was so fun.
I felt like it was all good, but some of the animations needed to be smoothed out. That's about
yeah,
it.
But
and
it.
Since it's
also
a third person game.
Yeah.
But one thing with Anthem that I really had a problem with was sometimes the sound design was really
bad. Alright, let me get these
skills.
Let me
bad.
Get these
skills.
Yeah.
Like something would sound like it's right next to you and it's 30 meters
yes,
away.
Yeah. Like a sniper sounds like it's right in your ear, but it's like on the other side of the map. Yeah, no, but a lot of the shit in Anthem that was, like, issues, I think, can all be related to crunch time and not getting proper development.
Yeah, and the fact that they just kind of dropped the game after they released it.
Yeah.
Like, if it kept going, they could have smoothed out everything.
Well, they tried, and they kept trying to give it support after launch, but, like, EA was, like, pulling devs from it.
Yeah.
And they're like, they didn't want the game... They didn't want the game to do good. Because what it ultimately came down to is EA, at the end of the day, did not want the game to do good because they realized how much time and effort and commitment it takes to make a Destiny-level shooter that people play... Over and over. And honestly, Bungie just got fucking lucky.
Yep, they were like one of the first people to do it.
Not even that they were the first, they just got completely fucking lucky, I think, with like just all the right pieces and all the right orders.
I think that also stems from just the design that Destiny 1 had. And the armor, because it was familiar. The armor and the weapons and everything were very familiar for like people that played Halo and shit. And that's what brought me into it, because it just all looked cool. And that's why I still love the Destiny 1 looking armor in this game. I hate the way the art direction. Bandex, toe shoe, fucking hunters.
Take that, son. Yeah.
Like, if Destiny 1 released how Destiny 2 did, I feel like it probably wouldn't have as big of a
following.
Yeah.
Probably not. I definitely think there's, like, some shit that would still have a good following for, because, like, I don't know, it's just got the correct formula that, like, the visuals added on top of it in D1.
Yeah, D1 though, like, going back to it now, kind of feels clunky, especially because the FOV is down a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
But once you get used to it, it feels really smooth. But yeah, now in Destiny 2, I mean... There's so much more mobility.
The speed has increased exponentially.
Yeah, that's why everybody uses SMGs and stuff. Like before, you couldn't get across a room in, you know, under 10 seconds. So you would have to use, like, a scout. Unless you were a Titan with fucking
yeah,
Gary.
Yeah, Twilight Garrison. Oh, another EDZ strike.
Lake. Spot to set up shop.
High forces are lashing out from the Cosmodrome led by a disgraced. This one looks really familiar.
Disgraced?
Like, you know what? It's like we've done this before.
Nah, I don't think so.
Oh. She'll be desperate to prove herself.
You know what? I think it's also the loot. The loot has to make you want to play, because there's been times where, like, in D2, there's nothing to chase, and I don't want that again.
Lots of movement ahead. Be ready for anything.
For me, like, that's where the gunplay comes in, where I just, like, I don't know what to do, so I just play to feel the game.
That's true. I feel like, recently, kind of, all the factors have just been kind of lining up again. I think it's a lot of the people they probably brought back.
Mm-hmm.
It makes the game feel like Destiny again.
Yeah, like that guy who's, pretty much running the show now. What's his name? Something Burn. That guy.
Blackburn. Mr. Blackburns.
Yeah, that guy seems like he knows what he's doing so far.
Yeah, he left the project for a while. Left Bungie, not the project. Then came back.
Fallen raiding party ahead.
I wonder if he was just fed up with what everybody else wanted the game to be.
Probably. That's what caused D2's launch. It was just people trying to pull the game in a bunch of different directions.
Yeah, like the whole competitive PvP shooter thing, that was such a wrong move. They want it to be like Overwatch, but also some PvP.
And you can't have. That's why I kind of get upset when people are like, this isn't a PvP of Destiny. Like, it's not a PvP game, dude. Like, where, like, it has PvP, but it's not a PvP game.
It's never really makes it seem like if they take out PvP, all the, you know, the game's gonna be dead, but I highly fucking doubt that. I don't play PvP at all, and I still have fun.
I think the definitely community would shrink a little bit, because there's a lot of people that come to Destiny just for PvP. And it's those same people that talk about how much, like, oh, they pick this and do this. It's not competitive. It's an arcade
shooter.
It's
funny, because I think the PvP gives it a big YouTube audience.
Feels like a trap.
Because, like, you don't ever go on YouTube really to watch people play PvE unless somebody's talking about a build.
Raid race or
raid race
solos.
Yeah.
And you're like trying to do it yourself and you're looking at guides.
But I do think that is a big portion.
I got a low altitude set on radar. Drop it back. Just them being able to talk about, like, oh, they're changing this and doing this, and they're changing this percentage to this. It's like, none of that really 100% matters in PvP. It matters in the sense that, like, you know, shit's changing, but TTKs don't really matter all that much by PvP.
Yeah, it's not as big of a deal.
Versus, like, when they're changing a gun and dropping the TTK like 0.4 seconds inside PvP, it's like, what the fuck are they doing?
The voter has no choice but to defeat. Energy signature. That's her. That's Navota.
Okay, that's good.
I don't want them to take PvP out of the game, though. It's fun to play from time to time.
Mm-hmm. Oh no. Shot the back of your head.
I somehow slipped in a little crack.
Why me? Why me? Why me?
They're never going to do it, but if they took out PvP, I wonder how that would affect kind of like online popularity of the game. Because like, Destiny is pretty popular, but like, game one raids come out, or like big things are happening, like it's constantly like number one on Twitch, number one viewed, like all that shit. Like, I wonder if hypothetically, yeah, just took that shit out of the game. Like, I wonder how badly the kind of views, quote unquote, on the game would kind of tank.
Probably quite a bit. Comes only
for the light. We're happy to send the message.
Right, I'm gonna take this to the tower real quick.
It's not interesting to just watch strikes. Ooh, what is this? Feeding frenzy, one for all spike on empty vessel. Kind of weird.
Huh. You probably brought one for all pretty easy with the blast radius.
Yeah. Might be kind of fun. Ooh, and hard launch, so I get lots of projectile velocity.
Mountaintop velocity. The speed to break the atmosphere. I already have 911 kills with this SMG.
Pretty good. You must hate it.
Yeah. Fucking sucks. Sucks my dick.
Buy more key codes. Wabam.
Oh, shiba. Wabam.
Whoa, I have 4 umbrals and a prime. Four umbrellas.
I do as well.
Oh, and another umbral in the postmaster.
Let's get started.
I'm out. Insight Rover. That is the most balanced king roll I've ever seen.
Ugh.
Look at this. Look at the balance on this thing.
Oh, sounds gross. Sounds grody.
It is quite grody.
Oh, Sarah's on Nessus. I'm an idiot. He was in the tower because he'd been in the tower for fucking like 5 weeks straight.
12, 10, 10, 11, 10, 12. Oh fuck. You gotta
That's
do
gross.
More like that, man.
That's just gross, yeah.
Yeah.
This guy modded G's Hunter looks kind of interesting. I dig it. I dig the look he's doing.
It's literally all white. It is cool though.
Jedi Knight. Here, I can take the helm, I guess. Actually, let me talk to fucking Ada and go to the loom. Finish one of my BOG shows.
Hello, Guardian. Welcome.
Oh my gosh, no way, I got arms. So cool.
Arms?
Yeah.
Arms dealer?
You ever heard of the arm dealer, man? Mine.
Even with the most difficult ciphers, all that requires is the right key.
That boy going to Idawon.
Yes, sir.
This war is a complicated
algorithm. What do you think? Home.
Got an Instagram ad for live Minecraft streams.
No.
just a Minecraft stream on Instagram Live.
I keep getting ads on Instagram for those stupid 90% of people can't solve this game. Download app.
Download now.
Oh, I get this all the time, the stupid games. Only 2% of the world can do this game. Okay, cool.
I yell at the screen when I see it because it's like some dumb bitch trying to do a puzzle. It's like, no. Oh, yeah. It's like, fucking idiot, they're all the same piece. They go perfectly into a cube, you fucking retard.
Yeah, I love those sewers. It's so easy to, you watch it, it's just... They do it on purpose, I feel like.
Oh, yeah, no.
No, they don't do it on purpose, but... No.
Oh, yeah, no.
Did you see? I think YouTube's starting to do that, too.
Yeah, I get shitty. Because
there was one time Kyle was like, yeah, did you ever see that 1320 video about this drag car and blah, blah, blah? And I go on YouTube, it's my first video that pops up. I'm like, what the fuck? And it's not, like, because I don't follow them, like... They rarely pop up stuff, but that it popped up that one day, and then we talked about something else, and it popped up something like we just talked about.
Yeah, phones are always listening to you.
Yeah, but I don't remember YouTube ever doing that though.
Well, now they do.
Yay! Bunch of little cunts.
Little fucking finger bangers. All right.
Well,
Binky babies. More.
Binky baby finger banging, bussin' boy, poppin' bussy.
Bussin'.
But I'm not a rapper.
Thank you, Nate.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You want to do override instead now? Full on keys and ether.
I am as well. Yeah, if we want to do overrides, we can switch to that.
Nick, you want to see if Kyle wants to do overrides?
That boy probably stoned. I mean, I'll go check, but I'm sure.
It's pretty late. I only have an hour or two before I got to get off.
An hour? Two?
Hour.
I didn't know they came out with an hour or two.
Just crazy, dude.
Yeah, crazy. That man gone.
That man gone?
That man gone.
Oh, real quick, I'm gonna take a spin this so I can get my second exotic from Zer.
Oh, boy, gay.
Thus. That is all.
What the fuck is this piece of shit?
Among Us.
This is me every single time I see an Among Us meme.
I will burn this planet down before I spend another minute living among these animals.
Among Us. It's not even funny. I don't know why I'm saying it.
Cause it's funny meme Among Us.
Make me laugh. That was a gnat that just landed on my hand while I was scrolling through my phone.
What is this piece of shit?
Like, why are you getting
Let's read some Snapchat news articles.
No. No.
This rapper's workout actually works, and it's some skinny dude.
Man, yeah, built like really a fucking telephone pole.
Must work really good.
Alright. Tragic details about David Batista?
You've been wearing your bikini all wrong.
I can guarantee you
I haven't.
Worcestershire sauce is made with aged garlic.
Worcestershire sauce?
Like sticking his hand in the dookie.
Poop. I click.
That man's got dookie shoes. Look at this dude got the dookie shoes.
The boy who can't stop biting himself. It's just some fucking retard in a chair. Like, actual retard.
Oh.
You Snapchat. We're making fun of retards now.
Man got no chill. You have to do him like that.
And it's... the name of the channel that posted it is Born Different. Of course he's born different. He's retarded.
Just built different.
Just built... Okay, if I ever go brain dead, I'm just built different. Oh, this is good. This is good. I am the ultimate Barbie, and I was born a boy. Nail painting emoji.
I don't think so, pal. I don't think that's how it
works. That makes me want to click so bad. I broke the cosplay world record with my giant wings.
Tits.
Wings. Oh. No. That's...
Oh, sorry. My bad.
It is your bad. Warning, this is the most insane way to give birth. And it's a frog with, like, pimples on its back. I think... I'm gonna give birth, I bet.
To a frog?
Yep.
Nice. sucker. How the fuck did that hurt?
Warning, this is a tapeworm coming out of a guy's foot.
Yum, yum.
Shit, bussin'. Shee!
I'm gonna just mute you now.
Like, what did I even do?
Satisfying videos to keep you calm, and it's a dude using a sander belt to shred a Kit Kat.
So satisfying.
That satisfies me. Oh, because Kyle. Yeah, no.
We woke him up.
Big sweet.
Oh, that's fucking gross. The coolest tech and the weirdest gadget. It's a painting brush, and it looks like a tongue at the end of it. Yummy.
Pain is beauty. And it's a dude covered in goop with fucking the ear cleaner thing sticked in his nose.
Now that's content.
Oh my god.
Crazy serial prank.
This one is friend reunion slammed as racist.
The Vex are not a destructive rabble like the Fallen.
Everything is racist now.
They have much to teach. I am here to
Nick is underleveled. This is probably not going to be fun for him.
I don't think he's underleveled.
Oh, I am plus 78.
1270. This is rated at 1300.
Oh.
Fine. Are things red for you?
Yes.
Oh no. That's not good.
Well, I don't know the everything, but here, let me see. No, not everything.
We'll just take them through it.
Oh!
Last night, I was using a lot of, or not last night, Friday night, I was using Terraba a lot in this activity, and it's really fun.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
Were you trying it with the boots?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Dude, I wish I had Terraba.
Buy it, can't you?
Yeah, but you gotta have spoilers.
You gotta help me.
a real one coming out, you'll probably, out.
Unless you get everything you want on like your first two runs, then probably not.
Well, the thing is, I want a full set of armor for my Titan and maybe my Hunter. So I'll be there for a while. For sure. Luckily, with ornamenting, though, I don't have to try to get like a perfect roll of every armor piece.
You just gotta unlock it.
I can practically hear the Vex gear grinding. They cannot stop you, but they will still try.
I just banked 10 motes. What are you talking about?
Okay, well, I'm almost dead.
A lot of notes up here.
We need one more batch of data. Then you can shove into the back brain space.
The portal.
That's portal.
That fucking RB mid jump with the turkey mid jump over mangrove.
The turkey.
That's what they call them. Turkeys.
Good old turkeys. Got him.
Tearing me right now, boy.
The subjugated mind will soon be revealed.
Well, got that virus.
I didn't get it. Oh my god. Circle literally completed.
Risky.
The path to the Vexnet is revealed. Into the vortex.
The
data you recover here will be invaluable to the future war cult. But not even Lakshmi can foresee the consequences like the of such a boon.
Let's try to just run straight through it.
Look inside, bad boys.
Oh no!
Oh, I don't have any jumps. That's such bullshit.
What?
Now I'm on
the thing. That's a fucking fucking lame shit, fool.
Ain't weird. My idol.
This must be the subject.
Like it or not, he has the body of a god.
So we can leave this hideous place. This
part's not gonna be fun for me. I'm gonna do that much right now. Fucking exactly.
Everything red.
No, it's not. It's just they do a lot more fucking damage than normal. Not everything's red though.
Watching the Star Wars prequels because I haven't watched them in.
Oh God!
I don't like the prequels.
They're not ones I rewatch.
Well, I haven't watched them since like 2009, so.
You probably remember them correctly, anyway.
Jar Jar is getting on my nerves.
Yep.
Oh, Misa stepping. Ooh, ha ha, funny, ha. Poo poo, ha.
Like, you know, he's.
Modern humor
more annoying.
Is legit just Jar Jar Binks. Think about it, you know what?
He's even more annoying than I remember him being. Like, in the Clone Wars, he's less annoying. And that's a kid's show.
Because it was well written.
It's a well-written kid show.
Yeah. Like, relatively speaking, it's pretty well-written.
Well, it's pretty funny, too, because my stepdad's a huge Star Wars nerd. One day I walked in, he was watching Clone Wars TV show. I'm like, you're a fucking grown man watching Clone Wars fucking TV
show. Whoa. Yeah, we're catching, like, every third word, Nick.
But I got the gist of it, though.
Yeah. Clone Wars wasn't bad. I liked it.
Well, I didn't understand at first. In line with everything. And
I can't. Oh, my God.
Hello?
Hello.
Oh. One in progress.
Which of that comes first, Mark? Nobody's gone in the portal yet.
Oh! Looks like somebody left this dude. There's just four of us in here. Unless the rest of them are inside the portal.
No, they're not inside here. He was just by himself for a while. Uh oh. This overload. Bitch. And a bit.
I'm coming.
You need to know that.
God, I'm coming.
Jenny. gonna sit here for a while.
Let's just get in position.
Positions? This is my position.
Vex are inbound on your position. Hold your ground and guard the connection.
Oh, what was that? I got booted so far.
That man bootied.
I got bootied hard, mate.
Unfortunate side effect of sword combos.
The passcode to gain deeper access.
They go, you know what? Let's increase my stuff. I'll drop those two swords.
Prepare for another assault. The Vex will endure as many casualties as necessary to keep the vortex closed.
Technically, you can cancel the fucking stomp if you melee at just the right time, I think.
And if you block.
Yeah.
But
well, I was just talking about if you're not using a sword, and like you're up close with like a shiny or something. I think if like you melee at just the right moment, you can cancel the shit.
Yeah, you can, but it still hurts like a bitch.
Yeah, it makes it hurt less, but it's just like being able to stay on top of the boss.
Yeah, I do that all the time. Melee so I don't go into the wall.
Yeah, it's being clung to the wall will sure kill you, versus being on top of the boss, you can try and still survive.
Fail. Epic grenade fail. Press refill ammo. Anything
good in there? Don't come inside the portal, I'm ready for you.
Too late.
Out with something like desperation. They are coming for you.
them to lock you out. The vortex is almost open.
Oh, this one looks
gold.
And in my visions, the data you secure here will fuel research for decades to come.
Man died before he even had the gun. What the fuck, dude?
Oh, no. It's so glitchy.
Yeah, it like pushes the thing back further than it should be for some reason. Like, I swear to God, I stand like right in the middle and it fucking hits me. I'm just gonna stay back here. I lost all my fucking charge points.
Crush their last defense to complete the splice. We have other networks to collapse.
Is he gonna teleport?
No, probably not.
So annoying. Can't it at least be consistent?
Huh?
I don't have any special moves.
That one. Let's keep beaming him with the SMG. Got it, fellas.
Oh, I got it.
Oh, man.
Wing.
That's what I get. An exotic drop.
Nice.
Triple stamp.
What is that dude doing with the data?
What is he doing?
Gotta hit the boss with it, right?
Great number. Lightways, adrenaline junkie.
Guardians continue to use the darkness. Some without issue, others. There have been incidents.
You see what became of Erebus.
The bad role.
But Mizrax also sees Guardians using the darkness to defend Alexei.
Nothing is ever as simple as it seems to the surface.
What, does it have any liens at all?
Or
is it like one of those like
high resilience? What is Kepri's sting? Punching someone with a full of melee energy will instantly cast smoke bomb. Gain true sight while your own smoke bomb. Oh, while in your own smoke bomb. What is true sight?
You see things behind walls.
Okay, so I don't.
Wall hacks. Basically.
Basic Cali.
What a basic Cali.
Yeah.
Wait, Cameron, are you pulling us into anything?
No, I'm taking us to the hell.
Okay.
The Hellamanema.
Das Helm?
Hellamanema.
Das Himalaya Mountain.
Subsistence wellspring on the fucking auto. Ugh. I'm gonna check out Tunic. I got D&D tonight. I'll catch you later.
Adios, amigos.
Let's see what we've got for each other. this schematic to read this schematic. Most unusual symbology here. Cryptoarchaeology is like agriculture. We work slowly, hoping our efforts bear fruit.
Well done. No. I remember this.
Recording data is easy, but recording data that can only be opened by those you allow to, now that is an art form. Cryptoarchaeology is like agriculture. We work slowly, hoping our efforts bear fruit.
Who said he could do that?
record, they wire your brain right into the ship. Some kind of crazy experiment. Oh, that's right. No.
The archives give it, and the cryptarchs make it into something useful.
Time for a break.
Are the archives finite, I wonder? Can a data set ever truly be complete?
Everyone's ready to serve these days.
Thank the Traveler for data compression. Now, if only we could get it uncompressed. The archives giveth, and the cryptarchs make it into something useful.
That's impossible. Awesome.
Great news.
How did you not watch the game?
You've got to be kidding me. You've got to be kidding me.
The archives give it, and the cryptarchs make it into something useful. All data has a lineage, no matter how ancient or corrupted. You can always trace it back.
Let me know next time you want to watch the Crucible, because I have my favorite.
Fire is the archivist's one true enemy. So has it always been.
From before the Traveler made it.
Hi.
Where did I put that blasted dematerialization lens filter?
Oh. Ah!